In this video, we are going to discuss about different types of thermodynamic processes like isobaric process where pressure is kept constant, isochoric process where volume is kept constant, isothermal process where temperature is kept constant, and adiabatic process where heat transfer is zero. So first we will understand what is the use of thermodynamic processes. Here the state of system can be expressed by various parameters such as pressure, temperature, volume, and internal energy. If any two parameters are fixed, like pressure and volume or fixed mass of gas, the temperature of gas will automatically fix according to equation PV is equal to RT. No change can be made to temperature without altering pressure and volume. By changing any of these parameters, the state of system can be changed. So the state of system can be changed by different thermodynamic processes. So here first is isobaric process in which pressure is kept constant. Since the pressure is constant in this process, the volume of system changes and work done can be calculated by the equation W is equal to P multiplied by change in volume, that is V final minus V initial. If change in volume is positive, that is expansion, the work done is positive, and for negative change in volume, that is contraction, the work done is negative. In isochoric process, the volume remains constant, therefore system does not do any work. Such process in which there is no change in volume can be achieved by placing thermodynamic system in closed container which neither contracts nor expand. Thus from the first law of thermodynamics, change in internal energy becomes equal to heat transfer. Now in isothermal process, the temperature of system remains constant. This process occurs when system is in contact with outside thermal reservoir, and change in system will occur slowly to allow the system to continue to adjust to temperature of reservoir through heat exchange. And since the internal energy is temperature dependent, and here the temperature is constant, so change in internal energy becomes zero. And thus, from the first law of thermodynamics, we will get Q is equal to W. In adiabatic process, no heat exchange between system and surrounding, so Q is equal to zero. So adiabatic process occurs without transferring heat and mass between system and surrounding. Since Q is equal to zero for an adiabatic process, from the first law of thermodynamics, we will get change in internal energy is equal to negative work done. Thus, internal energy will increase if the work done is negative and vice versa.